Caitlyn Jenner, whom I've met, wonderful person, Caitlyn Jenner was voted Woman of the Year. Her first year as a woman. Ain't that something? Beat every bitch in Detroit, she's better than all of you. Never even had a period. Ain't that something? Oh, I'd be mad as shit if I was a woman. I'd be mad if I was me. If I was in a BET Awards sitting there and they're like, and the winner for Nigger of the Year, Eminem, my man. And I found these notebooks and I started going through the notebooks and it was all this wonderful poetry in them, written as his handwriting. I didn't even know this nigga wrote poems. And then I looked through his drawers and I opened up his middle drawer and I found this rolling paper. And I looked down at them papers like, oh, that's where that poetry's coming from. And that shit broke my heart. I mean, I smoke weed, but I mourned my son's innocence. And I cried a little bit. And I took his papers upstairs to my room. Rolled some weed that I'd hid from the family. And I got really high. And then I got paranoid. So I put his papers back how I found them. But let me qualify the statement. I am what's known on the streets as a victim blamer. You know what I mean? If somebody come up to me like, Dave, Chris Brown just beat up Rihanna. I'll be like, well, what did she do? Dave, Michael Jackson was molesting children. Well, what were those kids wearing at the time? I don't think he did it. But you know what? Even if he did do it, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? I mean, it's Michael Jackson. I know more than half the people in this room have been molested in their lives. But it wasn't no goddamn Michael Jackson, was it? You know, America has a racial hot seat. I think we can all agree that that's the truth. And we can also agree that that hot seat is traditionally occupied by African Americans in general, African American men in particular. Although I can see that in recent years, that seat has been occupied by Mexicans, and I dare say Arabs. And we, the black Americans, would like to thank you both for your sacrifice and your struggle. We needed a break. We needed a goddamn break. We all go through something, but at least I can leave my backpack someplace. If you Arab and forget your backpack, you got about 20 minutes before they send that robot to blow your shit up. Then I thought of an idea for a children's book. The book is designed to help parents teach their children about racism, which, if you're a parent, you know, is an impossible concept to teach to a child. The book is about a big, strong, beautiful black man with a benign, regular-ass white name. And he has a white speaking voice. Whenever this motherfucker calls to get a reservation at a restaurant, oh, he gets the reservation. That name and that voice, who could resist him? Now, I should tell you, this black man is literally an actual giant. He's a strong dude. And when he shows up to them restaurants, they see that big, giant black dude. They say, you can't come in here. And they call the police. And in every installment of the book, the police come and they always shoot him. But remember, remember, this guy is a giant. These bullets don't kill him. They don't even hurt him. They just break his heart. It's called Clifford the Big Black Nigger.